My company of Green Howards was one of the assault companies on D-Day. We had to take a coastal gun battery at Montfleury. I was in charge of a group of 2-inch mortars laying down smoke. But I noticed that two of our platoons running up to attack the guns had gone past a pillbox. This was only about a foot above the ground, but I spotted a Spando machine gun in the firing slit. I went along with my company commander, one of the bravest men I know. They fired at us, but once we were on top of the box, grenades and Sten gun killed some of them. And when I went down inside with my Sten gun, I got half a dozen prisoners. It was a big place, 2 stories deep, and we got all the equipment intact, so that made things just a little safer for the rest of our company in their attack. The fighting all through D-Day was fairly warm, but one piece of trouble we ran into was on account of some dogs I noticed at the end of a country lane. There was nobody there, but the dogs were wagging their tails. When I went along with the Major, we found a German field gun supported by machine guns in a farmyard. Elements of D Company attacked from some farm buildings, but every time our lads got up on the next wall, they were knocked out by machine guns. I tried to get the gun crew with a mortar, but they started blazing away with a gun at 100 yards. Open sights and big stones were flying all over. The gun concentrated on one of our Bren groups, and things looked bad for them. They couldn't get back. So I tried again with the Bren, and this time the Boche got so worried, they left our lads alone, and we all got back safely. The field gun was taken later. Some days later, we had the hardest fighting the battalion has ever seen in the whole war. We had heavy losses. There again, another farmhouse held us up. Again, I was lucky with a Sten gun, from 15 yards this time. It knocked out all the Boche except one who came out of a trench, and I got him too. So we pushed on into France. Now, these don't sound like VC affairs, and I don't know if they really are. I do know it was the sort of thing that was happening all over in the first 5 days in Normandy. And jumping into a pillbox full of Germans wasn't so wonderful when you saw your own lads fighting like heroes on every side of you. And when you saw lads you knew dropping dead, you wanted to do something to smash the guns that have done it. Just after we were out of the water on D-Day, I saw one lad go down, wounded. Now, he saved my life in Sicily, and he comes from Middlesbrough too. That sort of thing makes you forget to be scared. I've always been scared when we've gone into action, with the BEF at Dunkirk, Alamein to Sicily. But if your lads see the Sergeant Major's got his head down, well, it's a bad do, isn't it? And once when we were shaving, I heard one of them say, "I felt lousy. I was scared stiff in case Hollis saw it." So that's the way it goes. And things like sniper's bullets on your cheek and being blown out of trenches and looking into German gun muzzles, they don't count as much as you'd think when you've got men like that round you. I'd like them to know that their telegram was the first I got about the VC. I've sometimes heard that chaps who get medals inspire the other men. It wasn't like that in my case. My officers and men, they inspired me.